Hi guys, today is March 1st. It is cycle day 12. And this morning I go in for an ultrasound to find out how big the follicles have grown and see when they want me to do my trigger shot and schedule my IUI. So I'm going to do that. And yesterday I also placed my order for the sperm, which gets shipped right to my house. So I called New England Cryogenic Bank and placed my order for the same donor that we've been using. And it costs $800 for one vial of sperm. And then you have to pay the shipping, which is $235. So it gets quite pricey. But because I'm working with the reproductive center now, they're actually giving me a 50% discount on each vial. So I'm only paying $400 per vial and paying the $235 to ship. So I received that shipment today. So we'll also be opening that up and taking a look. Now, while I was at my ultrasound appointment, the sonographer let me know that there were three follicles. One follicle was at an 11, and she didn't believe that that would be mature enough by the time we did the IUI, but the other two were at a 14 and a 17, and they want those to grow to a 20. So based on the growth so far, they're thinking on Monday, I will have a good size follicle to release an egg. And so they're going to have me trigger on Saturday, which is tomorrow. So I'm going to trigger tomorrow at 6:30 p.m. and exactly 40 hours after that, on Monday morning at 10:30 a.m., I'm going to have my IUI. So the trigger will tell the follicle to release the egg. 40 hours after that, the egg will be in place for the sperm to meet it when they do the IUI. Another thing that she mentioned while she was looking, because there was more than one follicle this month, whereas last month there was only one follicle, she did let me know that there was a 10% chance of twins, which we're completely okay with, but again, that is more of a high-risk pregnancy, so it's not necessarily something that we're trying for during this process, and it's not something that you want to have happen, but it always is a risk with the medication that we're taking and the process that we're using. Alrighty, so I've got the package here of sperm. Let's go ahead, open that up, take a look at what's in it so you guys can kind of see what it looks like when I get this shipment. All right, so this is the tank and it comes shipped straight from New England Cryogenic Center. It gets shipped straight to my house. Inside you have the return shipping label, so I will send it back to them. You also have all the information about the donor, which I don't want to get on video, but it does tell you which donor, you want to make sure it's correct, and it also tells you all their like medical history and their testing and stuff. So inside here, you've got your handle to pull it out because it is quite large and it is quite heavy. So they will take the sample out, pack it back up, and then I will need to FedEx this back to them. It is zip tied here closed, but inside there is the dry ice, which is keeping the sample alive. It's keeping the sample from thawing out and dying. So it does keep it cold in the tank. The sample can live for 7 days. So 7 days from when they ship it from their location. So when it leaves the facility, it can live for 7 days. Obviously, we had this shipped yesterday, so we'll be using it up within that time frame, but that is the full tank there, and it is quite large for such a small sample that is inside. Now, I just wanted to give you guys a little bit more of a perspective of what the actual vial looks like. So I've got a Yankee candle here, I've got a pint glass here, and I have two of my previous vials. So this is the vial that comes in the tank that I just showed. And inside of the vial, this is obviously empty because it was from a previous cycle. Inside of the vial, it's only really full about halfway. So if you're looking at the size of that tank and thinking I'm getting quite a large sample, that's not the case. The sample size is very small. But what they do when I go in for my IUI is they run tests on the sample and they make sure that it has a good count. They'll tell me how many millions are in the sample. They'll tell me if it has forward moving mobility, as in they're swimming straight forward and they're going to hit their target. So they really test it and make sure that it's a quality sample. Hi guys, it is Saturday, March 2nd. It is actually mine and Vanessa's 5th anniversary, but it is also the day that we're gonna do the trigger shot. So it is coming up on 6:30 p.m. On cycle day 13, and we are about to do the trigger shot, which we will show you. All right, so we've got everything set up to do the trigger shot. Get the needle, some alcohol, the bin to discard it. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Inspect the area. Gonna be right here. And then push the air out. Oops. Push a little too much. And then this is gonna go in. And done. All right, guys, so we just finished doing the trigger shot now. Exactly 40 hours after we do that trigger injection, they're going to do the intrauterine insemination. So we've got a 40-hour wait for that, and then begins the dreaded two-week wait. So we will be waiting, and hopefully I won't be testing and obsessively freaking myself out, but we will just be waiting 2 weeks until we go back into Northeastern Reproductive Medicine, where they will do the blood draw to see if I am pregnant or if I'm not pregnant, and we'll start another cycle. So stick with me. I'll put up a part three once we go and do that blood draw so you guys can see if we did conceive and get to hear what the doctor has to say about any future planning or what to do next. So stick with me for a part three that should be coming soon, and thanks for watching.